Welcome to the Black Rose Railroad, everyone. Really appreciate you taking the time out of your day to stop by and visit me, take a ride down my rails, and see what I got going on. I know I haven't been around too much. I'm sorry, guys. I've had a lot going on. But the doc is here. All right? I got something for you. First time on YouTube in O'Scale. I have to say that. I'm going to tell you a little bit about the real train, and then I'm going to tell you a little bit about Lionel's version that we have here. And yeah, I said real train. I know some of you guys may look at this and say this is out of Buck Rogers comic strip, but this thing actually existed. It actually ran very well. This is New York Central's M-497 jet-powered bud car. Behind it is the M-498 passenger. In the 60s, New York Central was looking to get into high-speed passenger rail, and typical 60s mentality, if you know anything about Detroit, was bigger motors. So they took the twin jet engines off of a B-36 bomber, bolted them to the roof of a Bud car, did a little streamlining fad work on the front nose, all hand done, and brought it to the flattest, straightest part of the New York Central system at the time through Ohio, and opened this puppy up, see what it'll do. Well, did 183 miles an hour officially, which, as far as I know, is still the American speed record on rail. It's rumored it hit over 200 during the testing, but the official was 183. Again, that's pretty freaking cool. After the testing was done on this, they recycled the engines yet a third time, and they used them in what became the famous jet-powered snowblowers that I know a lot of you guys have seen and some of you have. I just think this is absolutely awesome, guys. And Lionel did a pretty good job of doing justice to it. Now, understand, it's not Legacy or Odyssey, you know, it's old school, it's conventional, forward, neutral, reverse. It's got a really nice Pullman motor, Magna traction and traction tires. I mean, this thing, it's not a low-speed crawler by any means. Pullman are very twitchy and low-speed. But you give this a little juice, and it's going to do what it was designed to do, which is fly. I had this up to 16 volts last night, and it was pretty scary even in the 72-inch curves. Tonight, maybe we'll try 18, just for grins and giggles, right? So anyway, guys, Lionel, again, did a pretty nice job on this. It's ABS body on both pieces. Is interior lighting. The passenger car has window silhouettes, passengers, and the jet engines actually have little red lights in it inside, look, you know, flamish. A pretty good effect. The pilot you'll see square in the middle of the nose, that's a separately applied piece that comes inside the styrofoam with the traction tire. You got to put that on. If you're going to put it back in its box, you need to take that off again too. Be real careful. I mean, that's just, you know, thin plastic. I can see that snapping in half a heartbeat. But again, it beautiful detail, nice paint job, and like I said, I've been running this a little bit, and it really does run nice. It does also have a jet sound effect, which I thought was neat. Yeah, that increases in volume and intensity. Actually, the faster and longer you run it, which is another pretty cool effect. It's not controllable, though. It's just set. It does what it does. It does have a nice horn, you know, standard diesel horn and a bell. So give me a minute. I'll start this puppy up, do a little run by, and hope you enjoy it. All right, guys? See you in a sec.